Guess who's back? You missed me, didn't you? You totally missed your boy. I just know it. Anyways, look at that gorgeous pork belly. We're doing something exciting with it today. Today we are making something that is called tocino. It's a Filipino cured pork dish and we're going to start with a marinade. 3/4 cup of brown sugar, 1.5 tablespoons of salt, 3 cloves of finely minced garlic. We're using that frozen stuff that Allison likes. 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, 2 tablespoons of rice vinegar, 1/4 cup of fruit juice. We are going with pineapple, but you can use apple if that's what you're into. And 1/2 tablespoon of freshly ground black pepper. You can also add 1 tablespoon of rice flour. We're going with that. And if you want some red food coloring, but we're not doing it, we're just mixing it all up. And now let's move on to the pork. You can use any sort of pork you want. You can use a pork butt. You can use a ham. What we're going with is we're going with the pork belly. Slice up about a couple of pounds, give or take, of your pork and cut it into 1/4-inch thin slices. Then you're gonna put that in that marinade that we made and mix it all up real, real good. Really just get your hands in there, massage that pork. No, seriously, give it a real good massage. Legend has it that the people who make this in the Philippines, they'll massage it for hours and hours and hours. We just did it for a few minutes. We're not that hardcore. But the more you massage it, the more tender it gets. So massage it real good, stick it in the fridge. 3 days later, your pork has been curing for several days now. And it should be nice and lovely and ready, and we're gonna cook it now. So dump that entire container, marinade and all, into a pan and add 2 cups of water. Turn the heat on and let it cook and cook and cook and cook and cook. And you want all of that water to evaporate away. Now, if you're using pork belly, it'll provide its own fat. But if you're using a different cut of pork, you might want to add some oil at this point. Totally up to you, totally up to whatever you're using. But regardless, once all of the water has evaporated, you want to keep cooking until it is nice and fried and caramelized and delicious and smells so good. Oh my God, it smells amazing in here. But don't you go away and make sure to because something else is coming up. Allison's making a dish that's gonna use this tocino in the next video, and it's gonna be amazing. See you next time. Bye!